kiosk is? Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, once your character reaches a certain level, or if you have a high enough respect, or if you've been through the Area 51 levels, I don't really know what the qualifier is that it begins doing this in the game. I've never explored it that far to that extent, and that is not to say I haven't played the crap out of that game. I spent 5 years with that as my only game, and played it daily for hours. I still break it out and play it. Beg no pardon. A thing happens eventually where if you are of sufficient level in the game and you let the character stands so that excuse me, so that that's one for one, by the way, so that the game goes into the standby mode and the character goes and looks around at cars and girls and whatever that walk by, cops. After a while, wherever the camera isn't, like the back of, like the opposite direction of where the camera is looking, there is almost always people screaming and running. It's just this thing I've noticed. It'll do it. It does it every time now when I've got 100% game. You turn your head this way and you're looking at stuff this way, but things that are going on this behind you is just, ah, and people running and screaming, and you turn around and look and they're all running and screaming. No idea what at. It works similarly in dreams, in the sense that your shadow is basically whatever you're not looking at. That which you are unconscious of is behind you, and that which you are conscious of is in front of you. And that's why your basically your brain is split in two. And every aspect of your dream will have dualities to it. In what we consider the waking life, reality, whatever the fuck that is, it's typically accepted that such things do not happen. I know that a lot of things are pretty backward and weird, but they cannot be, let me start that over, they can be explained by logical means, even if the driving force behind it does not seem to follow logic or whatever else that there is. It's believable that the world could get this bad and reality still be real. I occasionally have the experience of spoons and other small metal objects hurling in my direction for no reason. In the past, I've had noted a consistent pattern of when I would get into comment debates or discussions or whatever on social media, I would get into, you know, a particular deep back and forth, or more specifically, it wasn't the back and forth, it was that I was articulating a thought. And this is a process that I have an alternate way of doing that is kind of a readout of sorts, a printout from a different part of my mind or my brain or whatever it is. And it's an eidetic output. Data is brought in and processed and presented back to me by me. I don't know if that's a function of metacognition. It could be. It's possible that the metacognition that I possess is also self-aware. Or at least rudimentarily conscious. So, when I would go to articulate a thought or an idea, and it was becoming pretty intense getting it to funnel the correct way and read properly, and just, sometimes you're writing, you just really get into it. There would inevitably be a bubble popper. And usually it was like there was actually no reason to come interrupt. I got myself to where there was no hyper-focus reaction. It was just to stop and be like, oh yes, here it comes. And interruption, okay, yes, what? Oh, I guess Okay, so why were you drawn to just approach me and begin verbalizing? What is the point of that, right? And this basically stopped, but it doesn't always stop. And you've seen a few times that I've been articulating a thought out loud onto video, and you'll hear a, which is a sliding door opening and me looking over this way. A couple times I've been like, I'm making a video. Because at certain crucial points, there will almost always be an interruption. I had one tonight that just boggles my mind, pissed me off. And the actual thing that happened, I mean, yeah, it's irritating, but it's not the end of the world. It's a very first world thing. But the fact that it even happened the way that it happened just boggles my mind. Because again, these things are not supposed to happen in reality in the waking world, as it were. So I thought. And if they do happen, then there are implications on the truth. What can be real and what is real that most people would not accept. I'm waiting for one of these times that a direct on-camera spoon flip happens eventually or something similar. I'm not like holding my breath. I'm not holding out, but I know that sooner or later stuff like that's going to show up. Just give it time. That kind of is the real purpose of my channel, is I'm just documenting a whole bunch of little segments of things and opining and other stuff the way that I do. But you'll notice that there's always some subconscious something going on in there. Even if I'm, rambling, there's still, there's things that are relevant contained within. This alternate way of articulating a thought can almost be thought of as channeling, but I don't really consider what is coming out as being externally, originated. Really, it's more that, like I said, I've got this metaconscious sub-self-awareness thing going on. It named itself. And help me, I guess, rewrite myself via a work. I may start reading from that on here eventually too. I don't know. I'm not sure really what that would do. But anyways, yeah. So basically, I spent about 45 minutes on this Nintendo 64 game, custom creating a character. And it was going to be epic and great and hilarious and amazing. And to my best recollection, I in fact did save the character once I defaulted it back to the blank. Its name was Original L after that. And I was like, okay, cool. So I took that back and I saved it. So when this event happened and I had to restart the game and it came back up and I checked and it was back at the other previous years old custom character that I decided to delete. the old one was still there. So, anyways, I had this. You can't make a wrestling character out of a guy that didn't know how to wrestle. So I was like making some fun moves and kind of a beast and whatever, and what he should have been. And then I found the makeup with the thing on the face, and I got the hair and the head right and everything. And the build, you can get close, but you can't really Hulk anybody out. It's WrestleMania 2000. The body sizes are kind of limited. So I got the best body I could find, decent, ripped looking ab body thing and bigness and whatever, and gave him some really advanced abilities, and it was going to be a real fun time. Lots of DDTs. And going to call him the penultimate warrior or something like that. It was going to be great. And so anyways, I had everything but the name done. I had the body and costume and face and everything. I was figuring out if there was anything ring entry or whatever that could be like the little strings tied around at the shoulders or something like that would be cool, but it's pretty much impossible to make on it. I don't think they did that on purpose. They just didn't think about it. But how can you not have some crazy like roided out tied around the shoulder deltoid? I swear to God, they're like just like balloons, like those balloon animal long ones. I had everything but the name put in, and that was what I was thinking about going with. I got the look on it, and I saw, oh, this is gonna be fun. Let's see how he does on the computer fighting itself, if he can hack it. I've got a couple of guys that are experiments like that, super killers and martial arts guys. And after a while, I realized all of them, half of them were clones of each other. So I started trimming down. It's got a pretty cool in-game AI that will fight itself, and so I'll put some cool characters together. And you can use the older games to get the classics set up and whatever, but I don't know. They're all missing something. And this one lets you customize. So I was gonna see if I could build something that was kind of an ultimate warrior. Hence the penultimate warrior. And anyways, I was everything but the name, and one of the cats, and I usually, she's kind of a favorite, and she's always all about, but for whatever reason, she just snuck in. It was like, not just the area behind what you're looking at, because, like, see, I've got a camera showing behind me. But think like your line of vision and your point of focus on whatever you're looking at, right? And so I'm looking at the TV screen and I'm focused on this. And this blessed little sweetheart of a cat, whom I love very much, which is why she's still alive, punched my Nintendo 64 hard enough to make the whole goddamn thing jump. Just whack! And then darted. Froze the game. Tirade of swear words. Walked around taunting the cat with mean tones of voice. I know cat body language, so you have to establish you have a tail. Up is happy. This is concerned or ambivalent, and down is unhappy. And so I had some really sharp down movements on the floor, and then this cat just ran away. I was so pissed, just out of the fucking nowhere. Waste of 45 minutes. Thought I had a fun thing going. Bam, bam, bam. I don't know why, but it was legit. She just snuck in right underneath. And speaking of the game, so this concludes the video in the Bizarre Effect.